Hello guys, welcome to a brand new video. This video is a follow-up of our previous video where we listed 20 business ideas you can actually start with little or no capital at all. So in this video we are going to explain step by step how you can get your freelancing account running and the step to guide you, give you some tips on how you can begin to get hired. Okay, so without much saying, let's dive right into the video. So firstly, what you want to do is to open your favorite browser. You open the browser, and when the browser is open up to you, you go to fiverr.com. Don't worry, we'll drop every link in the description box. Okay, we'll drop a special link here. You can get discount if you want to hire. Now when you visit Fiverr, this is what you see. If you have had some recent search, you see it here. Of course, I had some recent search where I was searching for someone who can do a particular thing for me. So you can go through here and literally get anyone to do anything for you, from logo design to video editing to translation, transcription, everything we listed in our previous video. You can actually get someone to do it for you here. Okay, now if you are thinking of hiring someone to do a particular thing for you, we are going to drop a special link on the description box, so you use that link so that you get a special discount. Okay, when you use the link to purchase any service, you are going to be discounted because it's coming from us. All right, so now what we are going to do is to click on this join now. As you can see here, join now. Okay, you are going to click join now. So we'll click on it. So when you click on it, it brings you to this particular page where it says join Fiverr. So you can use your Facebook account to join, use your email or your Apple account. Now guys, this everything here is secured, and you can trust them with your information because it's not shared with a third party. However, if you are not okay with any of them, you can put your email, the email you prefer to use to create the account. Like as for me, I already have an account created. So what I'm going to do is to click on already have account. I'll click sign in, or you click on this particular three dots and you click sign in now. So when I click on sign in, it brings me back to the same page, but this time around you notice some difference. Before now, this place was telling us join Fiverr, and here it was just a point for the email that we're having. Okay, but now you can see that we have email, username, then password. So the password is for those who actually use their email to create account. So for me, I didn't use my email to create account. What I will do is I'll click on this particular login. We continue with a Gmail, so click on it. It opens in a new tab. So you choose the particular account. We're going to choose my account. Now it's logged in. You can see that. So now that it's logged in, by default, when you open a create account with Fiverr, by default, it's going to create account as a buyer. Now a buyer is someone who comes there to look for services, pay for the service, and the service will be rendered to you. But that's not what we are here for. We are here to put our service on the marketplace. Now I'm using a mobile phone to do this video because I understand from a look of things and from some survey I did before starting this channel, I discover that majority of the people who actually surf the internet on a daily basis, let's say 80%, use their mobile phone. So if I'm using system like how I did in my previous channel, and I'm using system, some people begin to find it hard to follow. Why? Because the system will make everything boot for you. You see all the navigation and everything is clear. But for someone who does not have a laptop or a desktop, and the person has only mobile phone, person might be finding the navigation different. and it makes it following your video quite difficult. If you are using a laptop, of course, it's an advantage to you because you see everything boldly compared to what you are seeing right now on the screen. However, the phone is for the sake of those who, because the majority of audience has mobile phone, that's why we decide to use phone. Okay, so now let's click on this menu here. So you can see that's my picture and that's my name. Then what we want to do is that I want to switch. As you can see, this is my buying account. So now what you look at for when you click on this arrow, now this is the arrow you first of all click on, this one here, you click on these three lines to bring out the menu for you. So now you have the menu. The next thing you want to look out for is this particular one here, this menu, and you now look for the sub menu here, all this sub menu like this. So this is what you want to look out for. So here you can see learn online courses, so you can learn how the marketplace work. And then we have manage sales. Now if you have made some sales, this is where you see it. Then you see earnings, the money you have made so far. So here I'm going to go to manage sales, for instance, just to give you an example. Now you can see that because I'm creating this account for, I'm not really offering, this is not the account I'm using to offer services. I'm using this for the purpose of training. You can see that there is nothing here. Here you see I have, if I have anything here now, you can see the distinction. Here he said priority, active, we have late, delivered, and completed. Now all these things, what it means is this: for the priority, the order, when someone is placing order to purchase your service, Fiverr gave them opportunity to pay extra for the order to be delivered faster than when you say you will deliver it. So it becomes a priority order. Now for this other one, which is the active, it shows the number of orders that you have at hand. If you have two work orders, two people are waiting for you to deliver product to them, now you will see two different orders and their name. The late means the ones that you ought to have given out to the owner. You ought to have completed this and delivered it, but for some reason you are unable to do so. So it becomes a late order. The only thing you do in order for it not to enter late order is that you can reach out to the person. If there are challenges and you are unable to complete, reach out to the person and you extend your the order delivery date. Okay, so the delivered shows the orders that you have delivered, and we have the last one, which is completed. Okay, so that's for that. So now you can see there is no order here. The next thing I want to do is to come over and I want to go to, you can see earnings. So if I have made any money here, this is where you see all the money you have made. Like when it loads up, you can see there's nothing here because it's totally a brand new account. There's nothing here. Okay, so this is it, nothing here for now. So now how then do you now put your order online? So you come back here and you scroll, come to, just click on your profile, then you can, this one is for learning, learn from Fiverr, that's not what you want. So you come down, you can put description about yourself, what exactly do you do. Like here you say, have been developing website for more than 7 years and I'm good at what I do. Your satisfaction is my utmost concern. You can build anything you can imagine beyond your expectations and give you an edge above your competitors. So this description will be shown to the people when they actually check my profile. Okay, so you can come over here. I can just edit this, but I'm not editing anything for now. Then you when you scroll down, linked account, I only link my Google account. And the languages I speak, I said English. So if you speak more than English, maybe you speak French, you speak Japanese, you can add all the languages that you know there. Then the skill, what skill do you have? I place my own there. You can see the one I just placed there. Web development, digital marketing, and social media marketing. So you can add as many skills as you have there, maybe content writing, voiceover specialist, transcription, whatever skill you have, actually put it there. Sorry for this. You can actually put it there. So now, sorry for that break, that interruption. So now that you have already seen how you can set up your account, can you see the country I'm from and the time I joined this particular platform. So now we want to place our orders online. So what we do is that you come to selling, and in this selling, seems that I'm not seeing all the menu. So what I'll do is I'll click on this part, this particular arrow here. Okay, your own might be three dots, just three different dots. All you need to do is to click on it. Okay, so I'll click on it, then you scroll down, you see desktop site. So click on it so that the screen will be bold enough to give you more information in order for us to navigate swiftly. So what I want to do now, this is what I was expecting to see. So you can see that I have some of my gig that I have active gig. Now note, let me zoom it out. When it's opened up, this is when you do exactly what I said, this is what you are going to see. Should, in case you didn't see it like this, what you do is you look at to this part, because sometimes, let me switch to buying and show you what I mean. So maybe you saw something like this in the moment you switched, you click on the desktop view. There's no need to panic. What you do is you come over to this and switch to selling. Okay, so when you switch account to selling, then it brings you to this part. This is what you now see in your account. Okay, so here you see everything you about your account, your response rates, whatever. You can see all my own is being rated 100% because I always meet up to the people as at when I give them the time. So you see active orders here, active orders. As you can see, I have no active order because I'm not actually placing order in this particular account. So the next thing you want to do is that you want to create your own gig. So you see, share your gig. This is if you have already created your gig, you see that they have videos for you to watch, how to become a successful seller and all that. So now let's click on this menu again here, these three lines there. Okay, so let's click on it. Then when it shows opens up, you come over to sales, manage sales right here under the selling. So click on manage sales. So it takes you to this page, and here you see you don't have any order at the moment. So what we want to see is that we want to go for our gigs. We want to create a gig. So we are going to go to our gig. Okay, still loading. Okay, all right, so here we are. All right, so if your navigation is giving you some kind of issue, you are unable to find this page, just click on this, just follow up this. What is here, fiverr.com/your particular username, then you put every other thing you see here and it will show you the exact same thing you see here. So now what you want to do is you want to create a gig, but before we create our gig, you can see that I will write a nice creative story for you like no other. Now this is what people will see the initial time when your gig come to their site. This is the title they are going to see. So this title is vital because it's what you use to attract the audience to yourself. Now as you can see, there is no image here, so that's because this is actually inside draft. Okay, I didn't complete it, so you can see it's inside draft and I'm supposed to add an image here, and this is the price, say starting price. So you will learn all these things, how you can pick them. So if I come to active gig, you can see that I don't have any active gig at the moment. Then if I come to course, I believe I have some here. Okay, you can see that is post. So this one, I will do professional web applications development, and the price is starting at $500. So this particular gig, if someone should purchase this, it means that Fiverr will always take their percentage out of it, but it means that I'm gaining nothing less than $400 from this particular gig here. And if you look at this, this is $500 and this is $800. So if anybody should buy any of this my gig now, this is the exact same amount of money I will make from each gig. Okay, now imagine if you have up to 4 people buying your gig per month. That is some good money. So now, but I post them because at the time I created them, I had some other jobs at hand and it was a bit much, so I will have to post it so that I won't receive more order. Okay, so because if I have too much order and I'm unable to meet up, it will begin to reduce my rating on Fiverr. So Fiverr will be, because I'll be delivering certain jobs late, and Fiverr will begin to mark me as though I'm not meeting up on time, and it affects your score, your portfolio record. Okay, so now let's go to active gig. Now in this active gig, you can see what someone has said. Some of the reviews here is a great experience working with you. Thanks for the feedback, I appreciate it. So there are different, say it was a very good experience with him. The best thing about it is that, so these are some of the reviews. Okay, you might not see this in your own, but no problem. So now let's create a gig, because this is the actual part that we are interested in. So you click on create a gig. Okay, so now there is video to guide you along the line. You see how amazing it is, so you can click on this to watch the video and see how it can help. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is that you want to create a catchy something, a title that actually draws attention. So like you see the other one, I said I will do a creative content writing for you like no other. I will do a professional web development, so you know what you want to offer. So let's say for instance we want to offer we want to do video editing or website design, whatever it is, but for the purpose of this, let's go with video editing. So now you notice that when you click on it, the cursor is after the I will. So that I will is given to you, is added to anything you write. So when you are writing your gig, do not put I will among whatever you want to write. So just put, so if let's say you want to do I will do professional video editing with After Effects, you will not put the I will. So you say I will, then you put do professional video editing with After Effects and Quality Effects. Okay, so Okay, sell looks good. However, shorter titles sell better. So now you can see that you are being recommended that you should shorten the title. So what we do is we can reduce it to maybe this. I will do professional video editing with After Effects. Okay, so now the next thing you want to do is to select a category. Select a category. Of course, this is a video and animation, so you click on it, then you select a subcategory. Subcategory will be video editing. Okay, so whatever it is that you are doing, make sure you select the appropriate category. All right, so having done that, the next thing we want to do is I think we have done this. Then select the primary type of videos you edit. So what type of video do you edit? Do you edit video for online, say sports, movies and all that? So for the sake of this, I'll put maybe YouTube videos. We edit YouTube videos, and after that you scroll down, you see search tags. So in this search tags, you want to add some tags that can be used to search for you. Say for video editing is one tag, you separate with a comma. Okay, it's a 5 tags maximum, use letters and numbers only. So we have the first one, video editing. Okay, then you can add maybe FX, FX or After Effects Pro, put a comma, then you can say motion pictures, legend, or just motion pictures. Okay, let's make do with that 3. So you can zoom in. Okay, when you zoom in, you scroll down, you check if there's any other thing to do. So here we are done with this part. You can now click on save and continue. So click on save and continue. Okay, save and continue. You hold on. So it's telling you there is an error somewhere. It says tag list must contain at least one tag. Oh, I think we now have a problem. Okay, let's just leave it with video editing. Video editing. And then you press enter. Okay, it was not a comma, it's enter. Then we have motion picture. You click enter again. Then we have After Effects Pro. When you click enter, you can put maybe Adobe After Effects, Adobe Premiere Pro and all that. So you just zoom out, then you click on save and continue. Okay, so now we have another error here. Title can contain only numbers, so we remove this full stop. Okay, then we click this. Then let's hope there is no error again. Okay, it seems we are all good. So click on it again. And now that's it. Changes have been saved. So now we wait for it to load pricing. Now this pricing part is important, guys. It's important because that's what attracts the people. People want to go for something that is relatively cheap, yet it can give them the quality they want. So you see Fiverr has 3 different ways. You can see here we have a basic, standard and premium. Okay, so I will explain what these things means. Now the basic is the starting point of your video editing. Maybe you do a casual editing without After Effects and all that. So you can write here, say basic editing. Okay, basic editing. No after effects. Then you can put a description here. Probably the description will be edit your video without special effects. Okay, so you can write more thing about it. Then the delivery time, you click on it. How long will you deliver this product, this particular order? Is it one day? Will it take you one day to finish, 2 days? So I'm just going to go for maybe 3 days. So because there is no special effect on this, I'll go for 2 days. Then I'll come to footage provided by buyer. Now what this means is, is it the buyer that is going to provide the video that you will edit? Of course, the buyer will provide the video for me. So I'll say the footage is provided by the buyer. Okay, so then how many minutes will it last? I'm just going to edit a video of only 15 minutes. Then running time, so how long will the video run? That's okay, the video should run for maybe 10 minutes. Okay, now take note that these options that are coming up, they are coming up because we chose video editing. If you choose programming, other effect, other particular one will come up. So here now we have the opportunity to begin to choose different things. So now source file, first let's start with color grading. Okay, we'll do color grading for the person. Then sound design and mixing, no. For this particular motion graphics, we are not doing that. Subtitles, we'll just do subtitles and thumbnails for the person. Then we are not giving the person source file. Then here, how many times are we going to review? Maybe one. Now review simply means that if should the buyer of your order should make some complaint that this particular thing that is in your description, you said you will do this when I purchase your order, now I can't find it, you didn't do it. Revision simply means how many times are you willing to redo the thing or to revisit that particular job for the person's sake and redo it for the person. So we are saying one. So how much are we going to charge them? We'll say okay, let them pay maybe $10 for this. You remember you can put, but the minimum is $5. Fiverr does not go lesser than $5. So you can actually put as high as you want, up to $10,000. Of course, if you know that your service worth such, you should put it there. But you need to, your price should be a bit considerable, because the reason why people are coming here to look for freelancers is because they are running away from the big price. So if your price is relatively high, they will look for another person. Okay, so here we are done with the basic. So we'll go to standard. So here we'll say probably intermediate editing. Okay, then your delivery time. So let's say maybe we'll deliver this one for this time. Then the footage, okay, we'll say okay, also this one is also 15 minutes. Then we have this one is the time it's going to run, so it's also 10 minutes. We don't want to do more than 10 minutes. Of course, you can add your own time. Then we'll come over to this one, say professional editing. Okay, so here say editing with your special effects and Okay, let's just leave it like that. Okay, so now your delivery time, now this one, let's say 5 days, then the footage should be 30 minutes, and the time for this to run, we can say okay, this will run for probably 15 minutes. Then you begin to put color grading. Of course, we'll put color grading in this color. This one you can mark everything since it's the list and you are going to have everything. Then here we have sound mixing, we just give them sound. Then motion graphics, we ignore that. Subtitles, of course. Now you can remember, I'm doing this to show you how the system works. Okay, so now we have a thumbnail included. Yes, I think we should give this one thumbnail too. So it all depends on what you can do at a particular price. Then the price for this particular, how many times are we visiting it again, which is revision, I'll say 2. So we are visiting this one twice, and the price will be maybe $50. Then we'll come to this one, we'll revisit this one for, let's say 4, and the price will say maybe $150. Okay, so that's it for this particular section at the top. So now if you come down, you see another feature here, which is extra service. Okay, now you see extra service here. All right, now this extra service simply gives the user or the person purchasing your gig the opportunity to begin to either hasten the delivery time or add some other special stuff to it. So if you look at basic, you say I will deliver in only 1 day. You can say 1 day. If the person is willing to pay an additional fee of, let's say, $30. So now remember that in basic we say the person should pay $10. As you can see here, the gig price, this is the price. So you can see $10, right? Now we can say okay, if this person is willing to pay additional 30, we're making the total of $40. I will deliver the item in 1 day instead of, how many days would we select again, instead of 2 days. So if the person says okay, I can't wait, then can go for this. Then for this, it's okay, in only 2 days I will deliver if the person pay extra 30. And for pro, which is premium, say I will deliver in just 3 days if the user is willing to pay additional cost of 30. Okay, you can remember you can set all this to your preference. Then of course we are not going to select all this because we already marked them up, so ignore all these things. If you have any other additional service, you can click this particular one here. Okay, see, add gig extra. So if you click on it, you are going to type whatever you want and set the price. Then you click, when you are done with all these things, you go through it and review it properly. Then you click save and continue. So now we have an error here, so we should select. So here we are saying okay, I will deliver, let's see what it is. Say for an extra $30, I will deliver in 2 days. Let's leave it like that, 2 days. So just click save. If you don't want to set this, just uncheck this part. You get that now? So you uncheck it and you just click save, and now it's loading. Say changes saved. So wait for it to take us to the next, okay, which is the description and frequently asked questions. So in this description box here, you write everything about your gig. Make sure to be detailed enough for the people to know. Then if you have some frequently asked questions, you can start adding them. So questions like okay, what program, what software do you use for your editing? Do you do this? The questions that you know that clients or the people ordering your service may likely ask, you can put them there and provide answers so that they won't be bugging you in the in your inbox on questions that you already provided. Okay, so after that, you can come over here and put your description. Make sure you are detailed enough, okay guys. So for the sake of this, I didn't actually have some write-up and I didn't prepare any documentation or graphics for it. So you can see we have gallery. You will provide some images that people will see. Okay, so for the sake of this, since I didn't provide this, I'm going to go to my previous gig and use it to explain this step. But I believe by now you already know what to do. Okay, so I'll go back to my, I'll just click here and then we'll go to others. Okay, I think manage sales. Okay, if I can't find it there, I'll click on my profile here, and on my profile, I think just go to profile. Okay, so this is your profile now. So that's it. Okay, so now you see the one I was trying to do, I didn't complete it, so it's stored in my draft for me. As you can see, no image and nothing. The same thing with the previous one. You see the starting at $10, which is a basic price. Okay, so now when you, what I want to do is I want to go to my post gig. Okay, so I can use it to explain to you. So I'll just click on this first one, and okay, so now this is how it looks when someone visits my gig. Okay, someone can actually visit this gig and it can get a professional looking and responsive WordPress website for $500, 10 pages and just a description. Then you come here, you see multi-page web application. This one people pay $1,000, and for premium people